and welcome. Thanks for joining us. We've got the American League Championship Series on the show. It's the Seattle Mariners taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. Alongside my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us here. It's been a heck of a series so far, Singy, and you have to figure that will only continue here in Game 6.
You never want to be down 3-2, but we've seen plenty of teams come back from that, especially when they're playing the last two at home. So it's not an ideal scenario, but playing in your own stadium with your fans behind you probably makes it a little more doable.
And on the flip side, you really don't want to let this go to a Game 7. When the crowd's even more fired up, the momentum's against you, they're looking to finish this thing today. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So, almost ready to get underway. And on the hill in this one, Shane McClanahan. How about a report on him, Chris?
Well, there are going to be a lot of balls in play because of the ground ball rate. Important that the defense stays engaged in the game. I think it's critical. Tempo is there. If you work quickly, it helps the fielders behind you to stay engaged, to make those plays, and help you get through the innings.
So just about set now. Here's Adam Frazier. Next offering is foul back. Rip to third. Throw over to Choi. One out in the top of the first. Take a look at the lineup. The first baseman, number 23, Ty France. Now, here is Ty France. Good contact guy, good defender. Going to count one and two.
Count is one and two.
Swings and misses. That's the second out. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Jesse Winker. And a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And the Mariners set down 1-2-3. Mariners are down in order. Now it's the Rays' turn. No score. You're dialed into the show. Bottom of the first. Today's starting pitcher, Logan Gilbert. What do we need to know here?
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket. As a hitter, you really have to stay on your toes.
Next one misses, and that's ball three. And a pitch. Late that time, and it's strike two.
For this guy, it's truly a battle when he steps into the box. Only one thing on his mind, seeing that pitch out of the hand and hit it hard somewhere.
In the air, out towards left center. And puts the squeeze on that one. And there's one down.
Batting second.
All right, let's take a look at the Rays lineup. Here's Wander Franco. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Two away.
This guy will throw any pitch in any count. 3-2. He goes off speed, gets the out.
Now it's Austin Meadows. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. That one fouled off. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. Scoreless after one. Back now in Tampa Bay. Top of the second. So now it's the Mariner cleanup hitter, Mitch Haniger. 3-1 now. And that one is lifted in the air. Kiermaier settles under it. And it's caught for the out.
That is it. The third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. And Chris, probably no other player better represents present-day baseball than this guy. A lot of power, a lot of strikeouts, and some walks. Next offering is in for a strike.
Really important for the pitcher to not get proud, stay with the scouting report, and don't throw something into his swing.
He's kind of channeling Adam Dunn. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Already three strikeouts here in the early part of this start, so I think the guys further down in this lineup might need to take notice, take some notes, share some information. Got to bring a better plan to the plate, or else it's going to be a really difficult game. Disrupt his pitcher. Do something to get him out of his rhythm.
Two outs, bases empty. J.P. Crawford digs in now. Foul ball. No score here in the second. On the ground, Lau handles. Over to first, out number three. Nobody left for Seattle. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Bottom half of inning number two. Now it's Randy Arozarena.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
That's hard hit on the line. Lewis right there to make the grab. One up, one down.
Batting fifth, the first baseman.
And now the hitter, G-Man Choi. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. And the pitch. Not close with that one. And the count is 2-2. Our umpire behind the plate, Jerry Hillsdale. High praise for Jerry when we talk to people around the game.
Yeah, no doubt about it, Boog. He's very straightforward, very consistent back there. So most of the time, you're not even going to think about it. That's a good thing.
That one ripped right center field. And it's off the wall. And that's a double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
One out, runner at second. Now up for Tampa Bay, Yandy Diaz. And here it comes. Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2. Man at second. They say it went. Sends it to first. Two gone now.
Batting seven. The right fielder. Manuel Margot.
Here's Manuel Margot. It's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Two and one now. Bounce to the right. Frazier collects, throws to first, and that is that. The Rays strand just the one. We'll move to the third with no score. New inning getting started. This is Kyle Lewis. The pitch. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Choi racing over to make the catch.
Batting it. The left fielder, number 10, Jared Kelnick.
Here's Jared Kelnick. One check swing, appeal down to third. No swing. The wide to kick the pitch. And there's a foul ball. Next offering misses, and that's ball three. And down on strikes he goes. Two out.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Two outs. Base is empty. So here's Murphy now. Swings and misses. One and two. Top of the third, no score. Next offering down in the dirt. Now this one's crushed down the line. Hooking. Foul ball.
Clearly he was geared up for the fastball right there. Maybe got a little jumpy and excited out of the hand, but he certainly didn't miss a stitch.
Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Third out. And 1-2-3 go to Mariners. And we're still knotted at zero. Set for the bottom of the third, and stepping in for the Rays, Mike Zunino. Next pitch inside, and it's 2-1. And the right-hander deals. And that one is in for a strike.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
Swung on, belted. That's back there. And it hits the fence. Safe at second with a leadoff double. Here's Kevin Kiermaier. Left-hand batter waits. That's a base hit. And they get it in quickly. First and third now with nobody out. And now it's Brandon Lau. Throw to first. Kiermaier gets back easily. No outs. Runners at first and third. Right through there, got him. And one away. Now batting Wander Franco. Righty delivers. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Zunino, the runner at third. Kiermaier over at first with one away. Inside, and it hit him. And now the bases are loaded. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Fastball right there smoked him in the leg. At least it's in the leg and not in the wrist or the hand, but it still hurts, man.
Left-hand hitter waits.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball three.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
One out, bases full. Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
Payoff pitch. Stays alive. And he deals. And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step up and get the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty big two-out at bat coming up now.
Now here's the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Randy Arozarena. The pitch. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Lewis makes the catch, and that will end the inning. And the Rays leave them loaded, and we are still scoreless. Start of the fourth. Here's the Mariners' leadoff man, Adam Frazier. That misses the zone. And the count is 3-1.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
Fly ball to right. Margot drifts towards it. Makes the grab. One away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Ty France up next for the Mariners. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout, and there's two down.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
So now here's the DH, Jesse Winker. Falling behind 2-1. The wind of the pitch. Just missed.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Next offering finds the zone of the count is full. The wind of the pitch. And it's fouled away. The Mariners yet to pick up a hit here. Got him looking. Picks up strikeout number 7. Mariners go down quietly there. Still no score. Here at Tropicana Field, John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you, and leading off the bottom of the fourth, G-Man Choi. Next pitch is downstairs.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
So now 3-2. Swing and a ball popped up, and it falls. And the leadoff man aboard.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night, and just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. And the batter now, Yandy Diaz. He's 0-for-1. Next offering upstairs. Nobody out. Runner at first. On the ground, a second. Might be 2. To Crawford for 1. Plenty of time at first. That's a double play.
Now that is the right fielder. Magwell. Margot.
2 outs. Base is empty. Manuel Margot up to the plate. Grounded out his first time. 1-2 to Margot. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. That's the third out. Inning over. Through 4. Still tied. Zip, zip. Welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. And now for Seattle, Mitch Haniger. Swings and misses, and it's 1-2. Looked like it was a little bit up.
Really good take, especially with 2 strikes.
Two and two. Swing and a high fly ball, pretty well struck right field. On the warning track and hauls it in.
Now batting, third baseman,
And stepping in for the Mariners, Eugenio Suarez. He was a strikeout victim his first time. The M's hitless so far in the game. That hits the dirt, 2-1. Got a good eye there.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
And a pitch. And a swing and a miss there.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
That's a bullet, but it goes foul. And now the lefty. Ripped into right field, base hit. Makes the turn and heads for second. The throw is wild and it gets away. And he'll reach second with one away.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
And the batter will be the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss. One out and a runner at second. Next pitch is outside.
Really good slider. He's up there just hoping that it ends up off the plate away.
Kicks and fires. Snags it for the second out. And up next for Seattle, Kyle Lewis. Two outs and one in scoring position. And now a full count.
3-1 count, saying to himself, I've got to get a fastball here. Just spins a get-me-over breaking ball to bring the count full.
To third. Now the throw to first on the run. Third out, and that ends the frame. Mariners lead one, and we're still knotted at zero. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now, Mike Zunino. The next offering misses. 2-2. Bullpen activity starting up now. Justice Sheffield getting loose out there. Pitch. And now it's filled up. The kick, the 3-2. It's a leadoff walk, and that's the go-ahead run.
That could jumpstart an offense that's really struggled to score in this one. Don't want to wake a team up with a free pass.
Here's Kiermaier now. Runner at first with no outs here. Next offering is fouled back. the belt and fires. Oh, and now a wild pitch. Now a throw to first, but back easily. And a pitch. This one smoked out to left. Puts the squeeze on it, and there's one down.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
So the batting order turns over. Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Brandon Lau. He has, as they like to say, light tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing and thunder in that bat. Next pitch misses inside, and it's 2-1. Zunino leads off first with one away. Runner on the move. In the air out towards right center. Haniger in position. Squeezes it. And there's two down.
The batter, number five. Shortstop, Wander.
Wander Franco now at the plate. He's 0-1. Here's a 1-1. And there's a strike. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes a nice running catch. And that'll do it. One left for Tampa, and we are still scoreless. Top of the sixth inning. Here's the left fielder, Jared Kelnick. Kicks and deals. Popped up. McClanahan makes the play, and there's one down. Now it's Tom Murphy. The pitch. And that's through there for a strike.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Next pitch misses, and it's 3-2. Got him. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. Adam Frazier up next for the Mariners. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. Two outs. Liner, base hit.
Only two hits allowed so far tonight, Boog, so I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
Next to hit, Ty France. The pitch.
No bets off the plate. Ball two.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. That one back there hauls it in on the warning track. One left for Seattle. Still no score. Well, we go bottom six. Now it's Austin Meadows. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. He caught it behind his back, and they get the out.
Up next for Tampa Bay, no left fielder, Randy.
Next to bat will be the Rays four hitter, Randy Arozarena. Fouled off. He was late. Swings and misses at the breaking ball in the dirt. Murphy up with it to first. Out. Two away now after the drop third strike.
The first baseman, G-Man Choi.
Next to hit, G-Man Choi. And a 1-2. Fastball almost got him there. Straighten him up a little bit. The 2-2. Ground ball right side. On to first. Inning over. Rays held in check here, and we're still knotted at zero. We go to the top of the seventh, and now the DH, Jesse Winker. Here's a 1-1. And another ball.
When you get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there are some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
The 2-1. And that one wrapped foul. In the air, right field. Margot makes the grab, and there's one down.
Up next for Seattle, the right fielder, Mitch.
Now batting Mitch Haniger.
He's a big, strong guy, can untie this game with one swing.
The 2-2 now.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Next pitch is popped up. Diaz makes the grab, and there's two away. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
Well, we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
And here it comes. Fouls one off, 2-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Two two now. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Diaz has a beat on it. That is the inning. Mariners are down in order, and we are still scoreless. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Sergio Romo.
Number 54.
Bottom of the seventh, Yandy Diaz now. And the righty deals. Ground ball up the middle. Crawford picks it up on the run. Throw to first. Not in time. He's safe.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw, you know?
Yeah, no question.
Manuel Margot next to hit for the Rays. And a pitch. And that skips in the dirt. And here's a 3-2. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2.
Well, in this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
And a pitch. And Margot able to spoil that one. And ball four to aboard.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
First and second, no outs. Mike Zunino next to hit for the Rays. Next offering is in for a strike.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Righty to the plate. Stays alive. And the right-hander deals. That one missing inside. Diaz at second, Margot at first with no outs.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Comes a 2-2. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And that's the first out.
That's that classic wipeout slider below the zone right there. Just nasty. Looks like a fastball thigh high that you got to protect the zone, and then it's just that late break that fools you and kind of makes you look silly.
Two on, one out. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Kevin Kiermaier, one for two. Swing and a miss, and now two and two.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
Now all even up, and a foul ball, he stays alive. Two on, one out. Ripped on a line. Makes the grab on the run. Runner tags at second, and he moves up a base. So two away with runners at the corners.
Now back, second baseman. Right here.
So the Rays batting order turns over. Lau at the plate. Got to be careful with a slugger like this because he can turn it into a three-run game in the blink of an eye.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
Next pitch inside. Two balls and a strike.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Runners on first and third. Two away. Next one misses. And now 3-1. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
Right-handed reliever. Popped up to the left. Into foul ground. Suarez makes the grab, and that will end the inning. So the Rays strand a pair. Still no score. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Brooks Raley. He has a great slider with tons of movement. And welcome back. Stepping in, J.P. Crawford. Pitch up the middle. Franco on to first. First out in the top of the eighth.
The center fielder, number one, Kyle Lewis.
Here's the center fielder, Kyle Lewis. The 2-1. Fought off foul. And he deals. And he grounds one back up the middle. That's a hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield. Now a huge at-bat in this game coming up.
Jared Kelnick up next for the Mariners. The pitch. And a count 1-2.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Kicks and fires in the dirt. Now 2-2.
Well, with both starters out of the game, this quickly becomes a bullpen game, and this is something we see more and more in the game today, especially in the postseason.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Next offering is fouled back.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
Check on the runner, and he's back in easily. Here's a 2. And that one in the air center field. And going back is Kiermaier. Puts the squeeze on that one. And there's two away.
The catcher, number 2, Tom Murphy.
Tom Murphy up next for the Mariners. Next offering is down low.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. And there's a hit. And that moves the go-ahead run to scoring position with two gone.
Just an awesome swing of the bat, quick hands, and just launched the baseball. 108 on the exit velocity. Man, that is coming off the bat pretty good. I know he's feeling good about it. And a huge opportunity now to grab the lead at this point in the game.
Now, Adam Frazier. The next pitch misses, and a count 2-1. Lewis over at second. Murphy at first, two out of the inning. Bounced up the middle. They take the force out. That's the third out. Mariners leave a couple, and we're still knotted at zero. New pitcher for the Mariners, Eric Swanson.
Number 50, Eric Swanson.
Bottom of the eighth. Now the number 2 hitter, Wander Franco. That one the other way. Hauls it in for the out.
Now back, the designated hitter, Austin.
Austin Meadows now. The Y to kick the pitch. In the air, left field, down the line. In one hops off the wall, should be extra bases. And he's into second base with one away as the go-ahead run.
This was a really nice swing. Didn't quite get enough behind it to get it out of here, but once it got over his head in left field, it was extra bases all the way. A lot riding on this next at bat now as they look to take the lead at a critical point in this one.
One out, runner at second. And stepping in for the Rays, Randy Arozarena. Next offering is downstairs.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Next offering misses. Ball 3.
Lots of anxious fans in the ballpark right now. You can feel it.
Pitch downstairs and it misses. Ball 4. And here's the first baseman, G-Man Choi, for the fourth time tonight. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, but not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this.
Fires to second for 1. Return throw to first. Got him. Double play. And that'll do it. Game 6 is on to the 9th inning now. And we still have no score. We're back. And on the mound is the closer, Andrew Kittredge.
Number
number 36, Andrew.
And now for Seattle, Ty France. Next pitch is downstairs. Kicks and deals. Just missed. Righty delivers. And there's ball four.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Substitution being made at first. And here's the pinch runner, Billy Hamilton. And next is the designated hitter, Jesse Winker. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. Ground ball right side, could be two. Has some trouble with it, but the throw to first gets him easily, and that's the first out.
Well, that was clearly a double play ball, but the bobble unfortunately prevented him from being able to get two. But a good job to stay with it and make sure you got at least one.
And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger. One out. The go-ahead run is at second.
Yeah, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you're going to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
The next offering misses. 3-1. Runner edges away at second. And a foul ball. Runner leads away at second. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. And that's ball four.
Well, he took his chance at getting him to chase right there, but with first base open, walk not a bad thing. He set up a double play opportunity if he can induce a ground ball.
Here's a big power threat. Eugenio Suarez, 1-3. At the belt and fires. Little chopper rolls foul. One and two now. And a swing and a miss. And two away now.
Nice work there to get the strikeout, and that's a big second out. I'll tell you, this home crowd will be fired up. They can get out of this and leave that go-ahead run stranded in scoring position. This is a big moment in this game.
So first and second with two outs. J.P. Crawford, the next to hit. Lined into left center, should be extra bases. And that'll kick off the base of the wall. One run is in. Another comes in to score. It's 2-0.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Kyle Lewis up next for the Mariners. Man on second, two down. Late swing, fouled off. Down to the dirt, swing and a miss. In time. So the drop third strike doesn't hurt him, and that's that. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. And it's 2-0.
Welcome back. And here comes the closer, Paul Sewald. And he'll work on holding this lead. Dylan Moore getting loose there. He's now in the game at first.
Number 25, Dylan.
Back here at the ballpark, and now it's going to be Yandy Diaz. The 1-1. Late with the swing there. Sewald, he's known as a reliever that excels in really tough situations, those high leverage spots. It seems like he's at his best in these situations, and obviously the ability to get the strikeout factors in. Slow roller to first, and it goes just foul.
Yeah, there are certain guys that expect to come in and dominate, and they see the challenge, the battle, just a little bit differently. They trust their stuff, and they believe that their stuff is better than that guy standing in the batter's box, what his swing, what his ability is.
Snags it on the run. One down.
The right fielder, number 13, Manuel.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Manuel Margot. The mental approach is a big factor too, isn't it?
Yeah, Boog, it is. And, you know, for each guy, it can be a little different. Some people consciously work on focusing, slowing things down, breathing techniques. And then there's some players that are just natural, and they just seem to be more composed and less excitable.
The 1-2. And he chases that one. And there's two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's Mike Zunino. Next offering is fouled back. A lot of times with relievers, they just like to get amped up, and they're not really looking to try and slow it down, right? They're just trying to get hyper.
Yeah, and perhaps make that hitter a little hyper and make him more aggressive, and that way, when they put a wrinkle, change speeds, he's out in front just a little bit.
3-2 now. That one hammered center field. That's back. Turning, looking, and that one is gone.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Kevin Kiermaier. The 1-1. Now this is in the air down the line. Yeah, the Seattle Mariners are moving on. They are champions of the American League and headed to the World Series.
Congratulations to the American League champions. These guys have worked hard all season long, and their hard work has paid off. Now, off to the World Series. These guys can't wait to get it started.
From my partner Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew, thank you for watching the American League Championship Series on MLB The Show.
Final line score tonight. First for the victorious Seattle Mariners.